morning.
Good morning, everybody. And to the world out there, good morning out there. Now, it is nice to see a little bit of balance here and there on both sides. But we're still hoping and praying that we have continued to work more and harder for Him. By what? Inviting people to come over. So we need to build this God's house. Now, today's topic is what? As you can see, right there. True wisdom. Meaning what? Real wisdom. It is real. And we're also going to be reading in the book of James, chapter 3, verse 13 through 18. And first of all, we will be doing our reading together. And then we have two questions. And what is the question for everyone to know? Number two says, What does true wisdom mean to you and to people in the world as well? Because people in the world out there have a different meaning. So you will see when I preach about this. Second question is, how do we become wise? And then, of course, our conclusion. They're not the same. The world's different compared to Christ, Christian people. But the world people think all people are the same. No, sir. So next one. So let us go ahead and start our reading together. In the book of James, chapter 3, verse 13, says, aren't there any among you who are really wise and understanding? Then you should show your wisdom by living right. You should do what is good with humility. A wise person does not boast. Verse 14 says, if you are selfish and have bitter jealousy in your heart, you have no reason to boast. Your boasting is a lie that hides the truth. Verse 15. That kind of wisdom does not come from God. That wisdom, as you see the quote, means belongs to the world. That quote, wisdom, does not come from God. That quote, wisdom comes from the world. It is not spiritual. It is from the devil. Verse 16 says, where there is jealousy and selfishness, there will be confusion and every kind of evil. Verse 17. But the wisdom, the means specific wisdom that comes from God is like this. First, it is pure. Pure meaning clean. It is also peaceful. Gentle and easy to flee. This wisdom is only ready to help people who have trouble and to do good for others. This wisdom is always fair and honest. Verse 18. People who work for peace in a peaceful way get the blessings that come from right living. Meaning right way of life. You know, right living. Next please. So as you can see, there's pictures. This is going to be really simple, easy. What does true wisdom mean to you? If you notice, all of this means the word true means good, and the word wisdom means knowledge, good knowledge. All of this right here, I'm trying to show the world, you know, all the people can look at the picture because the picture explains it so much. It explains it different thousands of words. For example, live well and work well. It's important that all of us live well. Why? Anyone does not feel well, it's important to take care of yourself. Why? And you need to take care of your family. Take care of your friends. Take care of your neighbor. Take care of your church. Take care of school. Take care of job. Take care of the children. Take care of everything. You know, everything is important to take care of yourself. Don't abuse or hurt or destroy or fight or argue. Don't be negative. That's what it means. Live well every day. Control yourself. Fruit of the Spirit means have joy in your life. J-O-Y means think of Jesus. O means think for others. And Y, think of yourself. Use yourself at last. Be humble. Don't only use yourself, but the people of the world also need to do that as well. The more people in the world follow God's word, the better we are. We can have a happy world. We can. Like the fruit. Live well by eating well. You know what that means? People love to notice do you notice that American people, I've seen the news many times saying America is having the most fat people than many countries in the world. Why? It's interesting. In Africa, what do they see? America with big belly. They think we're rich because we can afford the food. They look down and they say, and I'm like, excuse me. Too many people are looking, you know, children are so thin. The first thing they do, they see that I'm black. They know that I'm deaf. They know that I go. They're so happy to see me. But when they look down, they say, ooh. They touch me. I'm just like, I'm just in touch. I'm like, oh, stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop. Oh, yes, it's true. The white brother was with me, 7 of us. They don't touch them. That's not, why not them? Oh, why do they get more close to me? Why am I more close? They got the same depth, they have the same skin color, they love, they hug me, they touch me. They're like, oh my goodness. And I'm like, hey, wait. It can be funny, but I've learned about it. I've learned a lot from them. What do? I tell myself, keep myself healthy. Not be skinny. Don't be big. Just stay myself. You understand what I'm trying to say? That's what we need to do. We need to take care of ourselves. I preach myself to take care of myself. My wife brings me, my friend. I exercise, you know. If I don't exercise, but I'm doing a lot of hard work. I walk. So why? I need to keep myself from being fat. No. If you don't believe me, come on. Come and see for your home. Go and see. Then you'll see the story. The story will be the same with me, okay? Now, look, here's a good idea. All should be thinking about bicycling, right? Bicycle ride. Good exercise. Now, I look at the picture, I'm thinking, maybe get 2-wheel bike, but maybe 3-wheel. 1, 2, 3. It's easier for me to control. So the old people fight, hey, it doesn't hurt. It's the same like a motorcycle. You know, they have a 1, 2, 3, and they're like, why not? You can be more creative. You can have exercise. Look at the very top. Oh, this is the wonderful man. He is bringing his Bible. Quiet. Smile. That's what we all should do. We should do the same thing. We need to find a private room and set it up. You know, have a small room in there means build your relationship with God. It's had that home. Look what it said. Live well home. The best thing in life built into your home. Good food, good book, good home. Of course, the Bible. Then other books, you know. Good furniture, good bed means take care of yourself, the family, the children, etc. More so, live well, work well. You need to keep employees safe. Employees. You know, that's a sign for employees right there. It means the workers. Those who are boss should take care of his workers. To make all the workers happy. Will make them happy to work for him or her. Benefit. To be fair. If you feel like you're in a wrong job, then what you need to do is stay patiently and work. Doesn't matter whether the boss is good or not. If you hold that job until you search and find another better job than this one, then you can let go of that job. It's important to hold on. You know, work until you find the perfect job. Then that job will be the same. Wait until better job, then you can transfer to that one. Don't quit. Oh, I should have not quit. I should have stayed over there. Mess up your life. Meanwhile, live well, be well. Be a good person. Whether it's man or woman, doesn't matter. Job, older, doesn't matter. And last but not least, live well means work well, eat well, learn well, and last, live well. Well. And then guess what? Some people, you know what? I'm tired of being good. No. You take a break and go take vacation. You see the older couple holding hands when they're out on the beach right there. You can have a good vacation, but preachers never retire. Never. Some preacher says, still retiring. But what they do, they follow the Bible. Never retire until means you have to work until you die. 24/7, every day. Means what do I do? How can you be a good person 24/7? But prayer, morning, afternoon, night, God will lift you up. He will lift good people to Christ. Christian people. Understand? Thank you. Now, same for the worldly people. Encourage them to what? To find a good church. There's plenty of good church in the world. But people say, oh, I can't do it. No. I can't find a good church. I can't find a good boyfriend. I can't find a good girlfriend. Why? They don't do the homework. They don't bother to pray. They don't ask God. They don't ask God. Guess what? Maybe people are lost. And the world is full of mess. Right. God loves so many people in the world. He gives the people somewhat gentle love. Some people, what? Tough love. Tough love can help. It can for some people. Okay, next please. Now, how can we become wise? The letter A. Wisdom begins when we ask God for it. Please give me some wisdom. Good people and bad people don't even know how to do it. And what do? God, give me the wisdom. Come on, give it to me. Come on. Think God will give it to you? No. See, wisdom is thinking and living right. As God helped us. Really? God? He helps us? Yeah, he does. Yeah, he helps us. I found myself, studying for 3 years in Bible school. And I asked God, can you help me to be patient, please? And I study until I develop a good study habit. And then I start to challenge teachers. Not challenge all teachers, no. One teacher I never forget. He said, Harward, you will never get 100 from me. Woo, boy, I was burning. What do? I kept my mouth shut, not been patient. I studied. I said, God, help me get a 100 from that teacher. Because if you spell wrong, put wrong words, he can be happy and he will take a point. Until one day, I was humble. I got up early in the morning. I studied. So I kind of drive down to school. I took that test and I wrote very good. I wrote, I prayed, and I said, God, please help me for this test. That very day, I got a 100. Wow, I was jumping for joy like a little boy. With born joy, I packed my bag, and guess what the teacher reacted? He started trying to search and he found one mistake. Spelling mistake, couldn't find it. And what was, mom, I gave him a kid. And teacher's like, his face became red. I told teacher, I said, what's wrong with you? You should be happy. I got 100. I said, yeah, great. I'm happy for you. I didn't stop there. I kept going. Letter C. Wisdom is the ability